everyone, this is Veronica. Today we are going to talk about Masai giraffes, which have been declared endangered recently. So we'll discuss in detail what are Masai giraffes, why they are declared endangered, what are the threats to this subspecies of giraffe. So you can connect with me on Instagram and Facebook, because I feel together we can make a huge difference. Now this is a channel StudyIQ. If you're preparing for any government exam, our pen drive and tablet courses are also available. If you're preparing for UPSC CSE 2020, our pen drive course is available, where you can find 100% coverage of UPSC vast syllabus. It has been prepared by top faculties of StudyIQ. Now you can buy this course at Rs. 625 per month only. And here you can find my social media address, Instagram, Facebook. Okay, now in what context today we are studying this? See, IUCN, that is International Union of Conservation of Nature, it is a global authority for the conservation status of all the wild animals and plants. You can say they maintain the conservation status. They note down it about the flora and fauna globally. So recently they have announced that Masai giraffe, so this Masai giraffe, they are the subspecies which are spread throughout Kenya and Tanzania, and they are now endangered primarily because of poaching and changes in the land use. So this subspecies in Kenya and Tanzania has declined by nearly 50% in the last 30 years, largely because of the two reasons. One is the poaching and other is the land use. Now this is the area in the map, you can see, where they are found, Masai giraffe, Kenya and Tanzania. This is the African continent. So now we will talk about Masai giraffe. Its scientific name is Giraffa tipples kirchi. So IUCN, this is a global authority, they have announced it. Now there are an estimated 35,000 Masai giraffes remaining, but their population has fallen by 50% in the last 3 decades. Africa's overall giraffe population has decreased by up to 40%. In the same time frame, Masai giraffe, they are iconic. This has been said by various people who have seen them. Given that they are one of the largest subspecies of giraffe, they are quintessential animal you likely think of when you think of giraffes. So for this subspecies to be declared endangered, it should be a wake-up call for everybody, especially the people who work for the nature conservation. So now see, the Masai giraffe, it is also known as Kilimanjaro giraffe, which is a remarkable species that is not only the largest giraffe but also the highest terrestrial animal in the world. So it is a part of Giraffidae family, which was described for the first time. They were discovered in 1898. So its scientific name is in the honor of Tipples Kirchi, who was a member of a German scientific expedition. So now when we talk about the anatomy, the Masai giraffe is a powerful due to the design of the legs and hoof. They are very powerful, so most of the predators avoid adults because one swift kick can kill them. So the adult males, they reach a height up to 19.5 feet and females are not much smaller because they reach between 16 to 18 feet. So their legs are about 2 meters long, like the neck, which is internally formed by 7 long vertebrae. So when we see their picture, as you can see here, it is very easily possible to differentiate the Masai giraffe from the other species mainly by the design of its fur stamped with irregular patches, which are darker in the dominant males, but generally they are of brown with several shades of such color. So as of all the giraffe species, Masai giraffes are native to the African continent, specifically to the savannas at the center and south of Kenya as well as Tanzania. So now if we talk about their behavior, Masai giraffes, they live in herds that are quite smaller. So they seem to be very tolerant of each other for most part, especially the females. The males tend to be aggressive only when it involves dominating the group or for mating rights, that they do not often interact unless they are looking to mate. So they move around through a home territory that can span around 50 miles. So these are the characteristics of the subspecies. So these Masai giraffes, they usually spend most of the time in a day feeding. So they are grazers. They can spend like 16 to 20 hours every single day out of their eating and looking for food. So that means they sleep very less. So there's no exact season for the beginning of breeding season also in them. They reach the sexual maturity between 3 and 5 years of age. So most males never mate until they are 7 years old because they have to earn that right fighting with other bulls. So if we talk about the threats to the species, so the primary predators of these giraffes are lions and hyenas. And regarding anthropogenic threats also, poaching is one of them from the man. An estimated 2 to 10% of the population is hunted illegally every year in Serengeti National Park in Tanzania. Now see, the primary predators of these giraffes are lions and hyenas. They usually do not target full grown adults due to their powerful legs and sharp hooves, but they are great danger for the young. Although they can camouflage with the environment because of the color of their spots, they are always at risk from the hunting techniques of their natural predators. Like lions, spotted hyenas and leopards target the offspring and wounded giraffes, but the first two predators are capable of knocking down an unaware adult if they are organized in a herd and attack various parts of the body at the same time. Now see, why people illegally trade for the skin and the bones of giraffe, poaching is there because there's a belief among that giraffe bone marrow and brains can cure HIV and AIDS. This has even reported by the Tanzanian media also. Now, why I'm saying they're forgotten fauna? Because giraffes historically have been understudied. If you can see, we can find a lot of research papers talking about rhinos conservation, elephant conservation, tiger conservation, but you can find very less research papers or such campaigns where they're talking about the giraffes. And even they're the most understudied as compared to other threatened species. We have so much to learn about giraffes, it would be a shame to lose them. For example, they have a complex circulatory system that could have implications for understanding humans' high blood pressure. So researchers have also found that they hum at night. Like a bee, you might have heard about that bee hum at night. So they also hum at night and they have no idea why. Now we have this species that's going extinct and we have these phenomenal, really fascinating things about them that we don't know the answers to. So that is why I'm terming it as forgotten fauna. Moreover, there is confusion about the species of giraffe also. Although for years there has been consensus that there's only one species of giraffe with 9 subspecies, evidence of genetic differences has emerged in recent years, which suggests that there are actually 4 species of giraffe and that the Masai is its own species. So usually right now we are discussing this article as Masai is a subspecies of giraffe. But there are many papers where we can find the genetic differences where we can refer Masai as its own species. Though Masai giraffes aren't widely recognized as a unique species, but if they are identified as a species, then they can reap more conservation benefits. So again, there's a map in this area of Africa. In Kenya and Tanzania, this Masai giraffe is found. And now if we talk about conservation, so we should know that currently there are no regulations on the buying and selling of giraffe parts since the animal is not covered by the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species, that is CITES. But in response to recent listings of giraffe, an organization of 32 African nations known as the African Elephant Coalition is expected to ask CITES to protect giraffes in a meeting in Geneva. And even a lot of people who are working for nature conservation, they are raising this issue regarding giraffe. So in situ conservation of Masai giraffe is being done, already being done, like in Kenya Wildlife Service, Tanzania National Parks. And then community-based wildlife conservation areas have also been shown to effective at protecting giraffe. So some steps are already being taken, but there is need for more. Because the extinction of giraffe has already become a reality in Senegal. This is a different country. Unfortunately, they have extincted there. So definitely right now we have to see for the conservation. We have to do a lot for the conservation of giraffes. So this is all about today's lecture. If you have any query, you can contact me on email, Instagram, Facebook. Thank you.